Good morning, buongiorno. My name is Peter. Do you see what I have in my hand? Yes, it is a rock. And this is a good rock. You know why I like the rock? Because it's a good rock for skipping. Raise your hand if you have ever skipped a rock across the water. It's a lot of fun, and it's very relaxing, isn't it? You take the rock and you throw just like this, right? Some people I even see, they put their finger like this, and they flick it across the neck, and they go skip, skip, skip. It's a lot of fun. But there's not a lot about this rock, is it? I can't just say to it, hey rock, skip, and it's not skip. No, 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 no. See, some rocks skip better than others. You have to have a nice smooth stone, and it has to fit in your hand. But that's about it. There's not a lot about a rock that can make it skip, including me. You see, my nickname is The Rock. Now, I'm not talking about the people's champion with the eyebrow. That's a different rock. That's a wrestler. I'm the rock that walk on the water. It's true. It happened one time. Well, okay, I did not walk very far, right? It was more like a hop, a skip, and a jump. But it was a very special day for me. In fact, let me tell you what I did. It was right after Jesus fed 5,000 people at the lunch. Do you remember that story? Yes, do you remember what he fed us that day? Fish sandwiches, that's right. He took 5 pieces of bread, 2 fish, made sandwiches, fed people. It was amazing. And then after that, Jesus told us, you go over to the other side of the lake and I will dismiss the crowds. And we were so thankful because we didn't want to deal with those crowds anymore. So we thought it was going to be just a short journey to the other side of the lake. But a storm was coming up over us and we did not see it. Now, I have to ask you a question. Raise your hand in the crowd if you have done this before. How many of you have ever stayed up to 11 o'clock at night? That's a lot of you. Okay, I ask a second question. How many of you ever stay up to midnight? No. Let me ask one more time. How many of you ever stay up 1 o'clock in the morning? Why? Why do you stay up till 1 o'clock in the morning? There's nothing to do at that time. Well, let me tell you something, kids. I was up one time till 3 o'clock in the morning. Yes, and I was not playing the video games, and I was not watching the movies, singing Hakuna Matata, and I was not talking to the girlfriend on the phone. Yes, I was in a storm, drowning, getting all wet, and wind was all over. However, there was something that happened then. There was something out on the water, and it turned around. It looked like a person. And he said to us this thing, he says, do not be afraid, which me and you would say something like, don't freak out, right? So he said, do not be afraid, take courage, I am here. And I looked at him, and I said, that's Jesus. My brother, he always asked me that question. He said, why do you say that question? I said, I don't know. Maybe I thought the boat was doomed. Maybe I thought we were going to drown. But I asked the question, and I don't know. But I do know what Jesus said. Jesus said to me, he said, come on. I said, what? He said, come on. I said, excuse me? I said, come on out here. So there I was. I'm a coming. Put 1 foot on the water. Stop touching me. Trying to put the second foot on the water. I know what I said. I'm going. Do not touch me. I said, here I come, Jesus. I'm going to walk. And I took 1 step. And I took 2 steps. And I was walking on the water. And it was a really enjoyable sensation. However, have you ever tried to walk when the wind was blowing? It's another difficulty. And have you ever tried to walk when the ground is moving? That's not fun either. And then I got scared. I said, this is a bad idea. And the minute I said that, I started to say, ah! And Jesus, I said, help me, Jesus! And he grabbed me, and he pulled me up. He had me, but who had him? I learned a lot about Jesus' strength that day. No, not the muscles, Jesus' strength, no. I learned a lot about the strength that he has for the people he loves. You see, he did a lot with me after that. Walking on water was just the tip of the iceberg. He said, I give you, Peter, the power to love. He gave me the power to heal, to forgive. I raise people from the dead, and I speak many languages at one time. Oh, he also gave me the power to get out of prison, and I'm very thankful for that. But you see, he gives us that strength. You need to know that when you are in those storms, you're not going to put yourself out. You're not supposed to. He is the one to pick you up and to bring you through the storm. You see, when you give your lunch to Jesus, he feeds 5,000 people. And then, when you give your life to him, he will help you through the storms of your life. And then when you reach out your hand and yell, save me, he will bring you up, even when you have sunk as far as you think you can go. You see, like we said before, there's nothing about the rock that makes it special. It's the person that is holding it. And when you put your life in the hand of Jesus, he will use you, and he will send you far, and you will do wonderful things, because God strengthens you, and he's with you wherever.